If you have not used Google Data Studio, it's actually pretty easy to get into. It's pretty easy to use. And today we'll just kind of go over a couple things. One is how you can connect to the data. Two, we'll go over some basics of designing visualizations. And then three, I'll just kind of show you how to create an awesome dashboard that you can share. So an example we have here is actually a dashboard we created at my company for some linear attribution modeling. And the cool thing about creating these dashboards is not only can share them with anyone who really has like a Google account, like a free Gmail account, but you can go in and really make these very interactive. So for instance, we have over here, say, an account manager. I could click on a particular account manager and it updates the whole report. So it's really cool to kind of see how your data can interact and create a very visual and powerful report. So the first thing is you just want to go to Data Studio and just do a search for it. The nice thing is Data Studio is completely free to use if you have any type of Google account, whether or not it's a paid, you know, account with your work, or you have maybe a free account, like just a Gmail account. That perfectly will work for this situation. So once you get in there, you would actually just click into there and you'll be able to take into this sort of a main dashboard within the tool. Kind of gives three sections. One are reports. These are the actual visualizations. This is where all the data comes together. You visualize it into a report that might have one page or multiple pages. The second thing you'll come across is data sources. If you just started, this will probably be blank. But as you bring in data sources, it will get listed here and you can actually interact with them, which is very powerful if you want to have other people to start using the same report and actually interacting with it and changing, say, variables and things like that. They're going to need actually access to the data sources, which once you get a data source, they'll have this little three little dots here, and you can go in and share, and you can give admin access to any of these. So somebody can come in and change them. For instance, we create these custom visualizations. In order to do that, you need to make sure that that's enabled on your data source. The last thing here is explore. This is something only just for you. So you can do an explore. It's basically a quick way to analyze the data set. It's based off of Looker's look functionality. So it works very much that way if you've ever used Looker. And you can basically come in, filter and play with your data, and you can actually save it, but it's really only saved on your particular computer so other people can't access it. So it's just sort of a limited thing. It is something they're kind of continuing to grow out. So I could see in a year or two this being a much more powerful tool. So let's just start with reports. So if we just wanted to click in a blank report here, the first thing they'll do is basically say you need a data source. You need something to put onto the page. The most common one I see is Google Analytics. Google Analytics we do a lot at my job. So if you just click on Google Analytics, you will see a list of all of your accounts. You can click on accounts. You can click on a particular property, and then you can click on a view. We'll say a reporting view. Add it here. What's going to do is going to actually make that connection, and then you say add it to report. And then it'll go ahead and immediately just dump a table right onto your page. This one has the page titles and then number of new users. But we'll get into that in a second. I did want to go in. If you want to start editing these, so if you go into resource, you go to manage added data sources, and here you can actually see that data source and you can edit it, which is really cool because you can go in and actually add new fields or change attributes of a field. You can also see this community visualization access. If you want to use any of the custom ones, say the ones we built or somebody else built like Supermetrics, you just turn that on and you save it. There's another thing with data freshness. This is how quickly the data is updated from the source if it's ever just sitting there. Now, every time you kind of reset that, it will pull the data set fresh. But if it's just been sitting there for a while and someone else is using it, say not an admin comes in, it might be a few hours behind. The other thing that you might find that's really cool is you can add other types of really cool data sources. You know, Google Analytics is a really common one. But for instance, I pulled in this data here from, this is from Wikipedia, of the list of the tallest buildings. So I just pulled in this table into Google Sheets, and then I could go over here into the report, click Google Sheets, and then I can actually see tallest buildings right here as one of the most recent ones. I click on that one. I actually go to the buildings table and then add. And I'm using the first row's header because it had a header row there of the title of all the columns. Another one thing you should, so if you click on edit, you can sort of see what are all the different fields. So we'll just close there, and then we'll close this out so we can actually go in into our data sets. So here, by default, it's going to create a table generally, and then it'll connect to one of your data sources. Here, you could switch it to tallest buildings. If I click that, it's going to kind of break this because it's not going to know the attributes you want to look at. So basically, there are two types of attributes. This is going to apply to all your visualizations. One are dimensions, which are things like categorical data, where you might have states, who's your source, information like that. And then the second thing are metrics. And metrics are the new numbers, how things are counted. What's the temperature? How many people came to your site? How tall is the building in feet? So we could go in here to dimensions, and I could click, say, the name of the building. And then over here, it's going to default to record count. Obviously, there's just one record for each one of the buildings. Not really a super useful chart field, but we could go in and look at some of the other ones, like, say, floors. So the cool thing here is it knows to sum this metric. So if you click here, you can actually change your type of aggregation. So if you just wanted the average number of floors, say you're aggregating building, and that's another one we can see in here. But here, this is just one row. So we have each building and then how many floors. So you have your data. You can kind of mess with the dimensions. You mess with the metrics. You can do a summary row, which is kind of cool, where it kind of totals everything up. Here we have a grand total of 6,212 rows. We actually expand this out. So this is a lot of buildings here, as you can see. But that's a lot of floors. Out of 74 buildings, there's over 6,000 floors. So the thing you can also do here is sort. So right now we're sorting by floors, but we can actually sort by the name. So we can sort by any of the chart fields that we're using. So we filter by name. This goes in reverse alphabetical order, so descending. If we click ascending, then it'll start with this one. Now, it has this null value, and I can actually go in here and remove that a little bit later here. If you want a secondary sort, you might be kind of cool. Say you have two things with the same name. For whatever reason, you can start doing a secondary sort on that. Now, the next kind of thing here is kind of cool is this filter. So you can add a filter, and then I can go and say remove null name. So I would say exclude, and then I would select a field of name, and is null. And I just save that, and now the null has been removed. And the cool thing too about this filter is if I were to create a new visualization, let's say, let's do just a simple bar chart. Here we have floors again, so we have the particular buildings and then all the floors. Let's just scoop this up and move this over here. We can now see them, and once again, we can go in and apply a filter. Oops, sorry. Add a filter, and then remove nulls. So we see that filter. So it's important to give your filter a nice name that you can find again. So here we have all it kind of organized from the most floors to the least in a kind of visual thing, which is kind of cool since these are buildings and it's tall. You can kind of get an idea of how much taller this this building right here is than all the other buildings. So that's kind of in a nutshell how to get the kind of core visualizations. As I said, you can insert any of these standard visualizations, a pie chart, bar charts, this combo chart where you're going to have two different axes. You can bring in maps. If you're familiar with pivot tables, those are pretty common in Excel. You can build them, a variation of them here. And there's a lot of different things here as well. The other thing you can do is, as I said, when we're building these charts, this little clicker right here is community visualizations. And here you can get to the ones that are made by people other than the people at the Data Studio team, although some of these are made by the Data Studio team. But these are a lot of different ones. For instance, we have a stat analyzer. We can come in and see if, you know, some variations of, like, say you have different sources and they have a different amount of traffic for each, and they each are converting. Is there significance there in how much one is converting versus the other, or is that just noise? You do a lot of really cool things here, gauges, sand key charts. But the key thing is you have to turn on that allowing the community visualizations, or otherwise it won't work and it will throw up a big warning. once you have these all up and running, then you can kind of get that up there. You can do a couple different things. One is you can click the view, and this is how this will be viewed through anyone who comes in and actually is just a viewer of yours, not an actual editor. If you click back to edit on this main thing, you can actually change the layout. So you can things like, is the navigation on the left? So you can have sort of like pages. In this particular instance, we don't have pages. If you wanted to create more pages, you could do it here. And then if you go back to view, you can see page one, page two, and page two is blank. There's a lot of other things too where you can kind of change the size. Here we are doing kind of a landscape. We could change it to a portrait or either of these other like 16:9 ratios. So anytime you want to actually edit the main layout, you do it just without clicking on any of the visualizations. If you want to actually go in and edit the style of the visualization, you click on a visualization. Instead of being in this data section right here, you're going to click style. You do a lot of different things. For instance, you could get rid of the header. You could get rid of the row numbers. You could wrap text if you need to, if you have very long text. You could say you want to show pagination, but maybe you want to get rid of it. You don't need to show all those pages. And then it'll become a scroll once people go to view. You can also do things like hide and show null values. So if we go into view, the cool thing, again, is you can kind of share this with really anyone who has a Google account. So you just go out and share. You can invite people, or you can just get a link. You just click on the share. It will just create a link of who it can be shared with. Get link. Here, anyone in my company can get it. But if I change it, I can actually say anyone with the link. So we just could share out the link, and anyone could go and view that. And they could just very quickly access it. But the last thing I want to kind of go over is, if you're actually creating this report and you want to share it, is this interaction here where I kind of come in and click this, and it changes the whole map, or all the different graphics on the page. What you do is go into Edit. You're going to click on your particular table or visualization. And then down near the bottom, where it's below Add Filters, you have this Interactions, and you have called Apply Filters. So as you are filtering this data, it's going to filter everything else on the page that has this interaction. So it's really cool, like, way to make the whole thing kind of play together nicely. So that's sort of Data Studio in a nutshell. Feel free to comment if you have any additional questions, and we'll